everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm back with another reading. I hope you all are doing good. Please take care of yourself. Specifically when I'm uploading this video, we all are going through a situation, so please take care of yourself. Let's start with the reading. But before we start, I would also like to express my gratitude to each one of you for all the love, support, encouragement, messages, feedbacks, for all the sharing, for subscribing the channel, and for just being in my space. Thank you so much. I really appreciate your presence in my life. So what you have to do is close your eyes, take a deep breath in, breathe out. Relax yourself. Ask yourself, what do you need to know in this moment? Second, you can also ask, what are you healing from, or what do you need to heal from all the level, mind, body and soul? So you can ask that question. Close your eyes, take a deep breath in, breathe out. If you want, you can pause the video while doing that. Whenever you feel comfortable, open your eyes, and wherever you get drawn to, this is set one, which is Jade. Second card is Pearl. This is Pearl, and this is Lavender. So just don't go with only with the favorite choice of color, but whatever you are getting drawn to, you may get drawn to multiple set of cards, and that is also completely fine, because this is a general reading, so you may have messages in the multiple sets, so you can get drawn to multiple. Then so just pause the video and you can check the timestamp below, which I will be putting downstairs, and you can see your reading. Okay, so let's start with Jade. Let me just keep this aside. So I have already pre-shuffled. This is wow, divine healing, and very well goes with the theme, which is green here, Jade. Take action, and this is divine healing. Probably either you can have this healing ability in you, or you are already healing specifically from some past experiences. Then it says boundaries. Where do you need to establish better boundaries? And if you see, there are a lot of hands coming and taking the energy. So you are in the process of creating boundaries where you do not let it deplete, where you let, you know, they come in the alignment. If you want, you can see the closer. So like you are coming in the alignment, you are not letting other people take away your energy. It says, where do you need to establish better boundaries? So either you are already coming, or either you need to do this. And this will really help you in multiple ways. We'll come to the details of the reading, but this is, I think, the theme for you. Another thing, maybe I will check from this, but later on. Let's see what are the other cards saying. So what are you healing from, or what do you need to listen in this moment? Wow, patience. I accept that everything happens in the divine order. Acceptance. I am learning to accept the things that I cannot change. So take action. Maybe you are coming in, you have already taken some action, or you are in the process of taking some action specifically with regards to coming in your own power. Okay, I also feel whether it is your relationships, whether it is your career, your finances, you are taking back your power. You are taking back all the energies that you have given back people, given to people in some time and space. But now you are establishing a boundary. If you are not doing that, then please start doing it. Because many people have taken from you and have not given that back to you. Of course, you were patient already. I feel you were already being patient. You say, I accept everything happens in the divine order. You have been patient. You are also coming in the power of acceptance. You are accepting, you are learning to accept yourself, you are learning to accept the situation, you are learning to accept people around you. You are learning to accept so much, because this acceptance actually is helping you in your healing. This acceptance is actually helping you to bring that shift. What is healing first? Healing is also about feeling of whole and complete. We know as an individual, as a soul, we are already whole and complete, but we don't remember that in our daily life, right? So when we talk about healing, what a healing means is that you are already whole and complete, but because of the experiences or the situations or certain people or, you know, certain circumstances, you may have lost your power, or I would say you have given your power to that situation or to that person, and now you are coming in your whole feeling of complete. And it says Hilarion, it says, honor your sensitivity, retreat to recharge and heal. Your light can support others. And see, to retreat you may have to, maybe, of course, right now we are going through a situation which is not allowing us to go outside, but whenever you get the time, whenever you are in the position to go in nature, go on a retreat. That will really help you. That will really help you to let go many things. That will also help you. I'm also hearing the word bountiful nature. Bountiful nature is all about that there is so much of abundance in the nature. You just need to be in nature and let the nature help you to heal. And take action toward your healing. Take action, or if you have taken already, that is really helping and working in your favor. Let's see, Moon Lightning. You can start working on your dream career part-time while keeping other job to pay the bills. Soon your dream career will take flight and fully support you. So if you want to change your career, if you feel that there is something different that you need to do in long run, start working on it, start taking baby steps. And if you are already taking baby steps, probably already taking action, it is going to work for you in long run. Don't worry about it, okay? It's going to work for you, but start taking action. And I feel some of you are healers here. Healers are people who are healing themselves, and then they contribute in other people's life to bring healing in their life. So you may be also doing that. That can be your full-time work, or that can be your part-time work, or that can be just being who you are. That doesn't, it is not always about what like work I am doing about tarot reading or therapies or Reiki or counseling, but it can be your way of doing healing by singing, dancing, by being an artist, or being like a chef, or anything that brings love in your work, and probably it is passed on to other people also. So that is what it is. Let's see what else. Surrender your habit of people pleasing. Speak your needs and be true to yourself. Focus on your own happiness instead of always trying to make everyone else happy. And this, see, the color also and the message also goes hand in hand. So you don't need to please people. You can always have a healthy boundaries. You don't need to do something to make you feel loved, to make you feel accepted, or to make you feel good about yourself, okay? So you can always focus on your needs. Specifically, this is about your relationship, because many times maybe in the past you have done things to please others or to make them happy, or you know, like maybe, see, this gives me a sense that you are a very 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 good human, and maybe many people come in your space because they know that you are that person who will not judge them, who will accept them the way they are, who will not like there are some people who give unwanted advice, or they they are not there, or maybe they just keep on giving some suggestions, but they are not there. But you are not like that kind of person. You are a kind of person who takes action. If you want to help somebody, you will not only be saying things, you will be doing things. And you know, the people don't want to leave your space, but you need to have a boundary, see whom you are giving. And if you are already learning, I feel that it will really help you in your healing. That is what I feel. Let's see more. God has flipped out. It says, sacred love, a feeling of connection beyond words, merging and coming together. Love, sacred grids, a calling from your beloved, twin flame reunion, strengthening self-love and sacredness. So this card has flipped out. So you are coming in the reunion. So this can be about relationship, but this can be also reunion with your own self, this sacred love, you know. So this can be, of course, about getting into a relationship. This can be about connecting to a soulmate or a twin flame or a partner. I don't like to label them, because labeling always restrict the feeling of love. So I don't label them that, but if you believe in it, probably it may be for you. The whole idea is, I feel here, is acceptance and love. Because you are coming in the acceptance, you are being very patient with yourself. And if you see, both the colors have the combination of this yellow and purple is here. Wow. So maybe if you are coming in the partnership, maybe one of the person is very patient and other person have this quality of acceptance, and this beautiful combination will help you to experience great love in your life. This can be for existing partnership, or this can be new partnership coming in your life. Let's see what else. I'll draw one card for each of this. Just to clarify. Patience, you know, 10 of Swords is also speaking about to me here that maybe that you have been to a situation where you were really hurt, where your energy was very drained, but now your patience, you know, is trying to tell you that yes, it was very good that you were patient with others, you were helping others, you were trying to be there for them, but now it's high time that you are with yourself, I feel. And then also let the divine order take place, rather than you trying and doing everything. You don't need to do everything. Okay, acceptance tells me about Queen of Wands. It tells me about, see how the person is sitting, how she knows how powerful she is. This is not gender specific. So she knows that how powerful she is, and here she is sitting and relaxing. Here see, she is walking away from something, and you know, the body language is very different. Somewhere, I don't know, I can feel some sadness. But when you are accepting yourself, see, the energy is shifting. So I think you are coming in the power of acceptance, which is making you realize how powerful you are, how magical you are, and that is really going to work wonders for you. People pleasing, so many people may feel that you are, because Queen of Swords and two queens in the same set, in the same reading. So I think that Queen of Swords tells me maybe many people will feel that you are arrogant, or you are, because they were benefiting when you were in this energy, and now they may feel that you are detached, you don't value people, or you don't care for them. But actually speaking, true people, like people who really love you, who really want to see you grow, who really want to see you successful, who wants to see you that, you know, that you are being in your true power, they will not mind you being in this energy. So you do not need to worry about it. And then if you start working what you love, if you are looking for a relationship, so you know, I feel that if you want to get into a relationship, start aligning with your life purpose. Start doing what you want to love, and this love will automatically come to you. Okay, maybe if you are feeling that, why am I not experiencing love in my life? So somewhere you are not aligning to what you love to do. The more you align to what you love to do, the more your chances of coming in this power of love or experiencing love will happen. Then sacred love, I feel that you are letting go of the baggages that you were carrying from the past. You are not anymore in that energy. You are already walking away and you are letting go, like you are not just leaving it. And if you are not yet, then you need to leave that, because that is not helping. And this is 10 of wands, this is 10 of swords. So, you know, two tens, so you are in the process of some kind of completion. I'll just take one more card for this. Wow, the High Priestess. I think what is happening? So the High Priestess, so I think, you know, you need to trust your intuition, be aligned with the universe to receive the sacred love, to come in the union of your own, you know, energy. This can be connecting with like-minded people also. This can be about connecting to love. This can be anything that makes you feel the energy of love. Okay? Let's see. What else is the message from the universe for you? Oh, I forgot the Tower. So again, the Tower is about transformation. You are going through a transformation. Okay? You are in the process of letting go. You are in the process of rebuilding yourself. This rebuilding maybe little makes you feel little discomfort, because it was not easy and it is not easy. But don't go with the idea of easy or difficult, because you know, when you were in a situation which was making you feel not so good about yourself, I don't think so even that was easy, right? So at least this discomfort, it makes me feel that it is leading you something something better for yourself. Okay, let's see anything else. Power animal. So if you believe in animal spirits, you can connect to an animal spirit. I feel that your animal spirit can be some kind of bird. It can be like a crow, it can be a dove, it can be eagle, owl, I don't know. I feel there is a bird. But apart from that, if you are getting some power animal or a repeated symbol of some animal that may stand something for you, let me know in the comment section if you have any power animal. Maybe my next reading I'll try and do that way, that what is the power animal spirit wants to tell you. But right now I feel that you connect with your spirit animal, that may help you. Let's see some messages from the deck, or from this is I have channelized the messages. So let's see. Also, I feel that your energy is little scattered, because yet you are coming in the energy of drawing boundaries. So maybe I feel lot of energy of other people. So please do grounding, connect to nature. If you in this moment, if you can't connect to nature, whatever plants you have, you can do that. Water the plants, or plant some like trees later on if you can. Or this can be also have food which is more plant based, that can also help you. grounding, like grounding, connecting to earth, which will help you to connect to your purpose. Okay. See your energy. I'm sorry, the card is. Give and receive. Universe is preparing you for some awesome breakthroughs. You have been giving a lot. Now it's time to receive. Very well goes with this. You have been giving a lot. Now it's time to receive. Then you are here on the planet Earth for a reason. You are drop in an ocean, but you are also an ocean in the drop. Love from heaven and spirit guides. So, you know, do not consider yourself that I'm not worthless, I'm worthless, or I have no value in anybody's life. No, it's not like that. You are a very important person. Please value yourself. It says your dreams are trying to guide you. If you see something negative in a dream, release your emotion. Probably if you have any kind of dreams which have little negative, like nightmares or something, please remove your release your emotions. That's a sign. Then it says you can affirm, I take baby steps towards my dreams. Every step I take takes me closer towards my goals. Very well goes with the jade and moon lightning, taking actions and baby steps. So let me just wind the reading. Let's see. I hope I've read all the three messages. Yes, I have. So of course, let go of your past drained energy. This also tells me take lot of rest. Okay, maybe you are healing. Take lot of rest. Let the baggage go. Do some breathing exercises, I feel. Have a very clear boundaries with people. That will also really help you. What else? Let's see if I can get anything from the boundaries message. I don't know why I'm not checking boundaries. 44. Okay, boundaries 44. It says you are being called to create clear boundaries in your life. This could be with your friends, family or work. Saying yes when you really mean no leads to resentment, which is big energy drain ever. At first it might only be a little bit and not feel like a big deal, but before you know it, your energy field becomes porous and you are left feeling depleted, resentful or taken advantage of. Saying no and having clear boundaries is actually a spiritual act. The most giving, loving, compassionate people are those with the clearest boundaries. For when they say yes, they are able to give unconditionally. When your boundaries are clear, others know where they stand and you are able to give freely. If you are not clear where your boundaries lie, this causes confusion, resentment, and energetic cords to be planted. If you are saying yes when you are really mean no, you are likely needing something yourself. Ask yourself, what part of me needs something from them? It could be need of for approval, a fear of being seen a certain way, or fear of loss. The best way to guard your boundaries is to check in your belly. Your belly is the second brain. It has intelligence known as your gut feeling. Tune into space when deciding what is okay for you. How does it feel? What is trying to communicate with you? Work your light inquiry is, where is your life? Do you need to establish better boundaries? So be in the question with yourself and allow your body to respond to you, that where do you need to draw boundary, where do you need to stop pleasing people, where do you need to accept yourself so that you will feel accepted by others, where do you feel that you need to accept certain people because they are who they are, you don't need to try and change them, you can only bring change in yourself. So with that message, thank you so much. I'm winding this. We'll meet in some other time and space. God bless you. Take care. Let's go to the next reading. Oops, I'm sorry. These were other two cards for set one. How can I forget? Okay. So maybe this also tells me that many times, you know, universe is also trying to tell you something. You just be open to receive that guidance and message, okay? I'm so sorry. Let's see. It says, I always trust the direction of the universe and know I am being guided. So as I was saying, trust your body, trust the message your body is giving. And then you can pray, admit the truth to yourself and act accordingly. I appreciate your support in helping me face my feeling with grace and acceptance so that I can be lovingly honest with myself and others. Thank you, Archangel Michael, for giving me courage and strength. So you just have to ask Archangel Michael to help you to admit the truth. Also, it will help you to trust yourself and your path. Okay? You can affirm this. You can write this affirmation also. Thank you so much once again. We'll meet in some other time. Let's go to the next set. Pearl. Hello everyone, Pearl group. Let's see. Wow, the Holy Spirit expects miracles. Remember that only love is real. Miracles will occur naturally. Spirit has your back. And okay, we will see this four together. Protection. Call back your power. Cut the cord. Soul retrieval. So I feel the changes are happening where you are cutting the cords from the past or any experiences that is no longer working for you. You are coming in your power and it is very much, little bit, I would say not very much, but little bit connected till now with the set one, which was Jade. If you are getting drawn, then please connect to that. Here the messages connect to the divine. So, and here is expect miracles. So you have to start expecting miracles. The Holy Spirit is working with you and through you. This can be for yourself and this can be for many other people in your space or people coming in your space in long run. Then they say worry. I am learning that worry doesn't change an outcome. So you are also learning the process where the worry should not change. Like the process will be, whatever the process is, it will take some time, energy, money, probably efforts, but worrying will not help. So you are already learning that, or if you feel no, I keep on worrying, that you need to affirm this, that I am learning that worry doesn't change an outcome. And then it says friendship. I understand that a friend is in my life for a reason. So maybe it can be you are worried for a friend, or it can be about you want some kind of friendship in your life. That can be another thing. Or maybe you have some issues with a friend which is worrying you, and maybe the person is, you know, like detaching himself or herself from you, which is again worrying you. Don't go in the energy of worry. Then it says clearing debts. Your self-care involves removing the heavy burdens of financial and emotional debts from your life. You already feel lighter and freer just by facing this topic and making a plan to clear present obligations and avoid future one as well. So your self-care is helping you to let go of whatever is feeling you burdensome. It is helping you in more than one way. So you can keep on moving towards it, because it says, you know, many times a part of you doesn't want to face that. Okay, maybe you have some debts which are emotional debts with regards to your relationships or friendships. This can be financial debts. This can be holding some resentment. So you are in the process of clearing debts, and the more you take care of yourself, the more it will help you. Surrender surrender to joy. A key to positive change in your life is to let joy in and savor it. Indulge in random acts of smiling during both the hard and the easy time. Keep surrendering to more joy. So you are coming in the power of joy. You are letting the worry part and you are coming in the power of joy. So keep on having this random act of smiling till you actually feel joyful from within. So suppose you don't feel joyful from within, keep on having this random act of smiling. Let's see what is healing energy card telling you. What are you healing? What do you need to know in the moment? Ancestral inspiration, healing through cellular levels, bloodline, let go of the old and move into the new. Meditation and ancient knowledge remembered, wheel of life, birth, transition, endings. Call your back your power, cut the cord and soul retrieval. I think you are healing from the ancestral patterns, from the ancestors, some kind of beliefs, ideas, thoughts, anything, you know, you are healing from there and you are now coming in your true power. Probably this healing is not only, only towards yourself. And anyways, healing is not always about yourself. Healing is also about when you heal your past, present and future. When you heal the generations which were there before you, the lineage. And you also heal the generation which is coming after you. So you are already doing that. If you are doing this, you are also asked to be joyful because you are clearing debts, right? And this may not make you feel good, but then eventually you will come here. Let's see, pick one card for oracle card. Tarot card for every oracle card I'm picking. Remember how powerful you are, strength. When you worry, you forget your powers. You are very powerful. So instead of using your power to worry, you can connect your inner strength. Okay? Then, so this friendship can be love. This friendship can be pure friendship or any kind of connection that you want in your life or you have in your life. Clearing death. Okay, these two cards have also come in set one. So clearing death, maybe in that it was people pleasing surrender, people pleasing habit. Here is clearing death. So maybe you are emotionally letting go and then you are coming in the power of Queen of Swords, which is also about good communication. You are coming in the power where maybe sometime people may feel that you are being very rude or maybe you are stubborn or you don't care. But no, actually it is not like that. You care and you know what needs to be done or what needs to be said and you are doing that. And that is actually helping you to clear your emotional depths also. Then, okay, so this is very connected to first set because let's see this also. Okay, this is different. So, Ten of Swords was also part of Jade set of cards. So, Ten of Swords, it says that, you know, like if you see the body language, you feel that, you know, she's not feeling happy. She's in the deserted island and or a deserted place. So maybe, and there are so many crows, so maybe there are a lot of thoughts going on. But see the body language changing from year to year, from being very sad to being very joyful. So you are shifting, your energy is shifting. You just need to make, right now, keep on smiling randomly, okay? Yeah, here also she is here alone, but the body language is different. The sunset is different, or the sun is rising, I would say. So, you know, and here if you see, the birds were all about her. Here, she is like a bird. Okay, this is not gender specific, this is about the energy. So you are shifting your energy. Then Queen of Pentacles, I will take one more card for this. Okay, Queen of Wands has come in that set of cards also again. Please listen to that set. I never force anybody to look into it, but I just get this multiple times, so maybe. Anyways, so you are healing your ancestor patterns and you are again, oh, three queens. And plus strength card. So maybe this is also female, so maybe you are also healing some ancestral patterns with regards to your feminine energy, I feel, where it was suppressed or where you have been not valued or you have not made feel good about yourself. That can be one thing. This is not gender specific, but I feel that way. Or it can be, yeah, if you are a male watching, you need to do some healing where you need to ask forgiveness with regards to females in your family. If you are already doing that, the more the females are happy in your space, the more they feel the freedom, the more you will grow. That's what I feel. Okay. What else? Anything else they want to say? Why it is this? I think I have to. Okay, parents. It says the divine truth is that your parents eternally love you to the best of their ability. The angels are helping you to heal from any pain associated with your mother or father. So yes, your parents do love you. You have to, I would say, keep on doing lot of forgiveness, one. I also feel that if you had some childhood experiences where your parents or parental figures were not giving you that kind of love which you feel that you should be receiving, they loved you, but they have given you the love they have understood love. Nothing right or wrong. And it says, I also feel maybe if you have lost a parent, maybe they are also sending you love from the heaven. The key to prayer is to forget that, it's to forget what I think I need. Okay, so the more you forget, suppose you want to manifest something in your life, you ask the universe and then let the universe work for you. You do not need to keep on thinking about how will it happen, when will it happen. You can connect to the divine and let the miracle happen. Expect miracles. But you know, don't keep on thinking like when will it happen. You have to just let it go. And then new beginning and fresh start. Thank you for bringing new opportunities and offering support, and for helping me release and heal my past. Fill me with trust as I experience this life changes. So you have to ask Archangel Michael to help you to in this new beginning and a fresh start. Yes, things were not easy, but they are helping you, and you have to just believe in it, and you have to expect miracles. I'm just seeing that if this book has more message for you, protection. You are being called to protect your energy and call back your power. May all the lost pieces return home now. Take a look at who and what drains your energy. Do not keep your tabs open. Shut down energetically each night. Energetic cords are formed between people, places, objects and events. So it's important to keep checking in. Your energy and energetic space are sacred, so treat them as such. Keep your energy clear. Keep your energy clear takes work. As we go through life, we can give away our power. So it is important that we call it back by cutting energetic cords or doing a form of healing known as soul retrieval. Can you think of a traumatic event, relationship or soul memory that you have been called to call back your power from? Check into your body now and see each chakra feels like it needs a bit of an energetic cleanup. You can work your activation by, because you are not having the card, you can just keep your hands on your heart and say, I call back any lost soul fragments, power or light now, any vows, soul contracts or programs from the past or present, from this life or others that are not in the highest good of all, I relinquish now any power or light that I have willing or unwillingly given away or had taken from me. I call back now any cords or attachments from this life or others. I release now for the highest good of all. And so it is, and so it is, and so it is. So you have to call back your power from no matter how, which time and place or lifetimes, across lifetimes, you have to just let it come back to you. So I have picked these three cards from what I have channeled. It says, you have come a long way and the universe understands that it was not easy. You still feel that you have a long way to go, but just pause in the moment before proceeding further. All can wait. You will not miss out anything. Angels, guides, applaud you for your hard work. You can affirm, I approve of myself. Then it says, learn from nature. Nature never asks you anything in return. It just gives. If you are doing or have done that in the past, you haven't done anything wrong. So if you have given and now you feel that you should have not done that, do not feel guilty about it. You did what you did. And this is specifically doing good actually, and maybe people have not rewarded back or given you back, but you don't need to worry about it, okay? Then it says, you can affirm, I am inspired by nature and willing to let go of whatever doesn't serve me. Okay, all are interconnected messages. And then it says 555, so you may be going through a major transformation. If you want, you can check my video where I have put messages with regards to 555. Maybe you have a message there. If not, just listen to this. What is the meaning of 555? Major life changes. It can be travel, curiosity, expansion, resourcefulness, pleasure loving, healing, sensuality, making important decisions, choices, auspicious opportunities. And then they say, there are expected or unexpected changes ahead. Do not fear, dear one, as all leads to perfect plan. Bring peace, bringing peace, prosperity. Change is only thing which is constant. Learn to accept and all will fall in place. So this was your reading. Let me just go through it if I get more messages. I feel you are coming in the power and you are also connecting to your soul tribe. People like, you know, you will come, if you haven't connected yet, you will be connected. And if you are connected, stay with them because it will help you or inspire you to keep on doing this healing or keep on connecting to your own self, letting go of your worries about friendship or about people. Again, very much similar. This will also help you to heal your ancestral patterns and get inspiration from your ancestors rather than getting anything which is not serving you. And because it is going to bring this new fresh start, and you have to just ask and just let it go. Let it go of all that is not serving you, your parents' programming also. If you feel that something is not working, maybe that past programming is not helping you to move forward, so you can let go of that. So this was your reading. I hope this was helpful. We'll meet in some other time and space. God bless you. Thank you so much. Bye. Let's go to the restaurant. Lavender. Hello, people who have selected lavender. Divinely guided change. I'll come back to this. The great gathering, it's all coming together. Intuitive heat soul tribe.
Wow.
Cosmic gateway. Your thoughts are magnetic and powerful. Miraculous changes are occurring. Okay. If you see, this is lavender and this is also in the same color. Right. Take a divinely guided chance. All positive change and successful ventures involves a degree of risk, and you are ready to follow your divine guidance to new territories. As you leave behind that which is comfortable and familiar but no longer appropriate for you, you make room for new and more meaningful opportunities. Change. I understand that nothing can grow or evolve without movements. Service. I feel good when I can help others. I'll come back to this later. And surrender your outdated beliefs about yourself. Let go of limited ideas about yourself that originates from the past. Then you can own your power and soar in life. It's beautiful. So I think this is very much bringing to me the energy of that you are shifting, your life is shifting, there is a lot of changes happening, and if you are not experiencing this, you feel, oh, it is not happening yet. I would say it is happening, but the process may seem to be very slow. You may feel things are moving very slowly, but actually they are moving, so do not worry about it. This is something I feel that your soul has planned before you have come on this planet Earth. Many of you are here to serve the humanity. You have come here to bring the shift in the planet's energy. That is the reason Cosmic Gateway has come. You have already healed a lot. A lot means a lot. And this is also tells me that 44 is the number, which is again an angel number, and this says that connect to body, mind and soul. So you are trying to come in the connection with your mind, body and soul, and that is probably making you feel more in the power of attracting, or I would say the law of attraction, which is again saying that your thoughts are magnetic and powerful, miraculous changes are occurring. So you are already coming in the sync. You are also being asked to take the divinely guided chance. Do not worry about the risk factor, specifically if it involves bringing some kind of changes or bringing some kind of service to others, or it brings something, like if you want to start your YouTube channel, you want to write book, or you want to share something or serve somebody in the universe, I mean the humanity or the planet Earth in some manner, specifically during this time, please do it. Please do it. You are being asked to follow that. If you are doing that, universe is already being praising you for that. Angels are applauding for your work. You are being supported. You are being guided. In the process, they also want you to let go of outdated belief about yourself. Like, don't think that, oh, what will my sharing do? So suppose if your life is already shifting in some manner, please share your experience, share your knowledge, share something that you know. The more you do that, the more you will grow, the more you will grow, the more you will be inspired to do. So take that chance. Many times I feel in the energy that you hold yourself back. Don't do that. So I'm just giving you example. You want to share your experience on this platform, you can. So if you feel anything you are getting from, reading a book or an article, or like even from this reading, or even from some random people crossing your path, you learned something and you shifted your life, or your life has brought something shift in, you know, like in other people's life also. Please share. Let go of the outdated belief about yourself. This can also tell me maybe you are also working on yourself through coming out of from low self-esteem. Okay, what else? Let's see, take a card for each. What are you feeling from? Let me not count it. Because there are two messages and I love the message, but energetic boost, replenishment, power surge, rejuvenate, crystals to recharge your energy, love, lightning balls, incoming light codes from beyond, help getting to the next step and teacher. So this can be in multiple ways, and I don't know why I feel it's well connected to me. And even this, because here it says that you are a teacher, or a teacher is important in your life. And there is help coming for the next step, and for that maybe they are asking you to take that divinely guided chance. This also tells me that you are protected, you are safe. There is this, you know, that your soul tribe or the soul group is protecting you. Let's see. Wow, service. So, you know, use giving service. I feel good when I help others. When you help others, you see this joy, this feeling good. You will feel this in your life, and you have this power to contribute in other people's life. This will also bring you happiness in your own life by serving others. One is because you will be happy doing this, and then universe will also give you whatever happiness you want, or maybe beyond what you want. But first, do this. Okay, and this is 10 of cups. This can also bring lot of good relationship for you. Like I was saying in another set of cards, I think in Jade, that when you are aligned with your life purpose, you will automatically connect to your soul tribe. You will automatically connect it to your partnership also. So please do that. It will help you. Or this can say me that your words, the spoken words, can help bring healing to families. Okay. Then it says change, key of pentacles. You are, I understand that nothing can grow or evolve without movement. So here also it is an action going on where people are working on one particular project. Okay. I don't know, I feel that this can be, you know, like something that you are working with other people. Again, here there are people. So don't try and do everything on your own. Ask help. One, it can be help from the divine also, or the help is coming your way. You are guided also to do work in team. Then devil, take a divinely guided chance. Do not let your old thoughts, emotions, ideas hold you back. Do not go in the temptation of your comfort zone. Let this chance help you. At the same time, devil is also about temptations. So, you know, temptations of only thinking about yourself. Sometimes I feel here, maybe many times you are only thinking about yourself. Don't do that. If that thought crosses your mind, it is just coming from the past. And thinking about yourself is not wrong, but the point is that when you think about yourself but you forget that how it is impacting others, that can be the devil energy, and which is very natural. You are not doing anything wrong. It's very natural to have that, but the minute you surrender your outdated beliefs about yourself, you will automatically come out of this, or maybe you are already coming out of this by taking this divinely guided chance. So surrender outdated beliefs so that you can come in the power of Queen. Also, this tells me be vocal about yourself, about your needs, and about see, I'm saying about your plans, but not to the people, but to the divine, I feel. Okay. Four of Cups. So maybe I feel that, you know, Four of Cups is an energy that will help you to take that divinely guided chance. Okay. It will help you to also bring love in your life. This will also help you to guide, take that guided chance in your life. This can be about relationship also. This can be about work. This can be in multiple forms. What else it can be? Let me pick one more card. Okay. So maybe you have gone through some kind of shift in your life and now you are tired. So take rest. If you feel tired, please take rest. I think because this transformation is there. So maybe you are going through some kind of transformation. And I also feel that maybe one of your purpose, maybe, I don't know, but because I am into therapies and where we connect to souls also. So if you are in that kind of work where you connect to souls, or when you help people to connect to people who have passed away, if you are doing that kind of work, please charge yourself also. Do not only doing service is good, doing for others is good, but this can be very tiring work. So please take care of your health, please take care of your body, because I feel that, you know, you help people to bring the completion. It's one cap. This is a general reading, but because I do this work, so I understand what this card is, and if you are doing, I think it will make sense to you completely. Yeah, because when we do therapies, we do connect to loved ones who have passed away. If you are doing that kind of, you are facilitating that kind of work, then please take rest. Okay, do not doubt yourself. If you feel that you need to connect to a loved one, then just take rest, relax. The more you relax, the more you take charge of your life, you will be able to connect to that person, I feel. But I feel this is more for the people who are doing this work. Wow, Archangel Michael, it says you are working very closely with this powerful Archangel who is protecting and guiding you through this situation, and this color is also about Archangel Michael. So let's see the message. Have confidence. Archangel Michael, please lend me your courage and fortitude. Help me realize that I am the one with all the divine wisdom, strength, love, creativity, abundance and health. Allow me to feel confident and peaceful about myself in all ways. I recognize that I have chosen fear, and I choose again, I choose love. So now you are understanding that you have in the past chosen fear, which has made you feel less confident, and that is also coming from outdated belief that you had about yourself. But now you are learning that I'm choosing love. I choose love, and because you are given a choice, as I was saying, you are given a choice, and this time you are making a different choice. But if you still doubt, please work with Archangel Michael. He will help you to connect to yourself, to help you to bring that confidence. Let's see what else. And I'm just picking three messages from the messages that I have channeled. Responsibility, I take full responsibility of who I am. So these are some affirmations. If you want, I have made a video on responsibility. If you want, I will put the in the description below. But this is the affirmations for responsibility. I rejoice in fulfilling my responsibility, and I feel this is more to do with the service of others. I am my own responsibility. I am responsible for my health, wealth and happiness. I am in control of myself. I am only responsible for my act, efforts, thoughts and ideas. So I'm just reading now this for you. So your words, your behavior, your are the consequences of your actions, and that only belongs to you. You have a healthy boundaries. What other people do is their responsibility, and you respect them. Then it says, to receive love, you have to give love. Do not forget to include yourself while giving love. Love is a vibration, it's not just a four-letter word. Check your belief, of course. And you can also affirm that I am balanced, I give and receive love. So it says, go ahead, step by step, don't try and jump or miss the step. So if you have any thought or, should I do, should I not do, they are saying, please go ahead, but don't take baby step, don't try and jump. So it's like if you want to get into a relationship, don't get into just feel that I want to feel the love. So don't go to the last step of a relationship, don't rush. Take step by step. Every step will help you to build confidence. It will help you to bring trust. It will help you to experience love. This is just an example. But this can be for... So some examples are very, though I say that's an example, but some examples are so apt for a particular situation. So you can apply this in your career also, or your finances also, or anything that you want to do in your life. Okay? Connect with Archangel Michael, very strong message. You can also keep lavender near you, or color lavender, you can use more. You can also use lavender oil, that will also help you. I also feel maybe some of you go through this little nervous breakdown. Or you feel little anxiety, so lavender will help you to cut down your anxiety. This will also help you to bring protection, because it's a sign of protection maybe. So you can use lavender for that. Of course, it will help you to connect to your mind, body and soul. So this is a reading for you. I hope this was helpful. Thank you so much for coming in my space. We'll meet in some other time, and stay lots of love. Bye-bye.